Hello everyone, this is Billy. If you've been following my channel, you know that I've created these 3D printed parts for the FM Crystal Radio. Today I'm going to finish the product using this circuit. This is the frequency discriminator circuit. You can follow the link in my blog to understand how this circuit works. This is how it looks in the front. You have two variable capacitors using copper plates for the moving plates and the fixed plates, and then in the middle you have the coil. The coil must be wound in the same direction, otherwise it won't work. On the top you see a white socket with two diodes. Those diodes are 1SS106. You can also change it to 1SS198. It has similar output volume, or other diodes that can work in the FM frequency range. This is how it looks under the case. So we have the variable capacitors, terminals that are the M3 screws that are screwed into the copper plate, and I connect the copper plate directly by soldering to the coil. This is very important because you can't use very loose wires or long wires to connect the LC circuit together. They must be soldered together to attain the highest Q factor available. Otherwise, the FM circuit will lose everything and you can't hear any radio. And you can see that I use some 0.5 millimeter magnet wires to connect from the coil to the circuit on the top. You'll find something that looks like a resistor. That is actually the choke coil, 30 microhenry. And then underneath there is the 50 PF capacitor that does the coupling between the primary stage LC and the secondary stage LC. And then on the right, you see the white socket that connect from the diode to the remaining of the circuit. You have two green capacitors. They are the major capacitors, 2000 PF. And then underneath there are two 47K resistors. If you have a transformer, step-down transformer of 2 × 10K, you can actually replace this capacitor and resistor with that transformer. And then the second stage of the transformer will need to match with your headphones impedance. Say if you are using some very low impedance headphone, like the 50 ohm sound powdered headphone, then you can choose the output transformer for 50 ohm. Or if you are using some other type of moving coil headphones, 500 ohm or 1000 ohm, then you can choose those as the second stage transformer. But finding those transformers is not easy. I haven't been able to find one that works well, so that's why I still do with the resistor and capacitor circuit. I'll stop here and show you the testing video. The audio recording of the testing video is direct from the crystal radio through a step-down transformer to connect to my iPhone that records the video and the audio. There's no amplification involved. I have connected this crystal radio to my self-made Yagi antenna. It measures 1.7 meter long. It's a folded Yagi antenna. You can find the 3D print files in the blog. The link to my blog is in the YouTube description. If you like my video, please share with your friends, subscribe and like. And you can support me by going to my blog, look at the description and what parts you can buy to make this interesting FM crystal radio. Thank you for watching. Now I'll show you the demonstration videos.
中學咧係要話安排教職員咧做一個定期嘅檢測，咁但係如果唔做呢個檢測，就可能影響生活，就係灰。 就你嘅學校好似咧，就係願意做呢個檢測嘅，嗱，你可唔可以同我講下你哋嘅情況點啊？個經驗係點啊？
我哋嘅情況都係即係教育局係有個需求出咗啦，咁希望咧就係我哋業界都係同埋家長都係好希望咧可以係盡快去復課嘅咁。咁但係咧就要求咧就係話，如果教師係即係有即係必須要檢測啦，咁可以全部復課。咁如果有教師係唔檢測嘅咧，咁啊得三分一嘅即係小朋友復課咁樣咁啊。
Thank you. 係咯，頭先我咁講，究竟係咪成？